history, on our family history. In the Hendrick family tree, there's a few branches. I don't know them all. And that's why I'm doing this documentary, because I want to know more about it. All I know is there's so-and-so and so-and-so and so-and-so and so-and-so was the daughter and the niece and the aunt was the cousin. I don't know. So what I'm going to do is try to go and learn about my branch, the Jacob branch. And I encourage you all to do that. But I'm going to take the cameras along with me, and hopefully we can chronicle some of the stuff that we're trying to do. Talk to my great-grandmother, talk to my grandfather, talk to my great-aunts, travel. We might go to Baltimore. We might go to North Carolina. We might stay here in Richmond. Who knows? We're just going to bring the cameras. I have some gas money. I just checked my oil, so feel free to come along with the ride. Bear in mind, that's not his car.
Are you leading me in the right direction, like not towards the tree?
All right. Yeah. I like that. Well, we're in Richmond. You can get ready to hit the
phone. I'm going to be asleep.
Yeah.
Just for a few minutes.
Yes. Well, yeah. Oh, yeah. See, we can chat with this doctor.
I said, you know, I'm all mixed up. I said, because my granddaddy is white. I said, and my grandma was not his concubine. That man came to this country. Most of them were thieves, killers. They were prisoners. And they wouldn't get them out of England. The prison was overloaded. So that's the way they got here. They put them on a ship with Columbus, and they're here. All right, they come here. The Indian got a good name for the white man. Got a funky tongue. They come here lying to the Indian and kill them. You know about that part of the history, I know. And he's doing the same thing in the other countries. That's why he is hated so, as America, because he been dominating ever since he been over here. Now, and he's trying to dominate the world, and he losing it. You hear me say white man, right? And the reason I'm saying white man, because in slavery time, the white man had brought the black folk over here for the survival. Okay, and he wanted to make sure they stayed in their place. If a white woman was showing too much partiality towards that black, we talking about teenagers or not. He took a missing. They either sold him or they killed him. And that went on in my lifetime. So I can tell you about that's why that pistol down there. And two clips, one in the pistol and an extra one loaded. Extra clip loaded. Or you hit the button and the empty would drop out in your hand and you slip that on it.
you born again?
Oakfield Township. Post office in Macon, North Carolina. In Warren County, North Carolina.
For what year?
1934. April the 3rd, 1934.
And what time, and what year did they move up to Baltimore the first time?
In 1942.
Oh, okay.
Beg your pardon, 41.
Okay.
They moved to Baltimore the first time in 1941.
So I guess, how did the Great Depression affect y'all when y'all were in North Carolina? Did it, or was it just what y'all were used to? Or would I have to ask great-grandma about that?
Well, I reckon Mike can get a better answer from Mama.
Okay.
I would say, according to what some people have told me, they had to go barefoot in from the spring until wintertime come again. They had their time, they didn't know where the next meal was coming from. Or they may have skipped, didn't have nothing, they'd skip a meal. But my memory of, I never was ever hungry. There was something on the table at meal time. Even if it wasn't nothing but brown gravy and biscuits or cornbread. What we call brown gravy today, we used to call it thank you ma'am gravy back then. Because today, said today we had the meat and some gravy. But the grease, the excess grease from the meat, maybe the next day or two or three days later, we'll make a brown gravy out of that and we'll sop that with our bread, mix our bread with the gravy, and we made a meal. Mm-hmm. Might not have no meat, we had the gravy and the bread. All molasses. My daddy always had a cow. So we had milk and butter.
Yes, right. This looks familiar to me.
Okay.
So were you like a good student in school, or were you like average, or?
I was just about, oh Jesus, did I do that? I was average.
What was like your favorite subject in school?
Math and science.
Like, what did you want to be when you grew up, when you were little?
I said a doctor when I was little.
Mm-hmm.
But that was just a dream. An army grab man.
Army, like in the draft or?
Yeah, draft.
Did you want to go in?
Didn't make me a whole lot different, really. That's the attitude I had. It just didn't make me a whole lot different. I wasn't gonna volunteer.
Did you have like a certain feeling about the military? Like maybe like this was a white man's war type thing?
No,
or was it?
No, I didn't have that attitude then. my attitude was, my mama said, I hope you don't pass the examination. Mm-hmm. And I said, no, you hope I pass. You just hope I don't be called. That's because if I don't pass, something serious wrong with me. Mm-hmm. And I think I was examined in May of 53. And I was sworn in July of 53.
What type of experience did you have when you were in the military? You have any comrades that you just became good friends with, or any like bad drill sergeants or really bad experiences?
No, I didn't have bad experiences. Yeah, there was two fellas that were very good friends. Thomas Hollins from Eufaul, Alabama, and Benjamin Jacob from Eufaul, Alabama. We are real good friends.
Were they black or white?
They were black.
Okay. Were you guys segregated at the time?
No. We finished basic. And then all three of us went to cook school together. But we separated from cook school. But I went to Korea, and I think they went to Germany. I think they did.
How was Korea?
It was all right. I was in the Army, but I was attached to the Air Force. I was in an Army engineer outfit. Mm-hmm. We built airstrips, but I was a cook.
How were the women?
Good women. Well, no women served when I was in.
Nah, I mean, but while you were traveling.
Oh, okay. We had Korean prostitutes.
Okay.
And?
Sorry, Grandma.
I was young. I engaged in the situation back then.
Yeah, it was just, simple conversation. Innocent.
It was a white boy in our outfit. Every time you saw him, when he wasn't on duty, he was reading a book. And he was taking college correspondence courses. And I look back over my life now, if I had been that smart, my life would have been different. I don't know if it'd been better, but it would definitely have been different. So that's why when Kay went in service, I said, don't waste your time like your daddy did. I said, that's when she went to Germany. Mm-hmm. That's because I was in Korea and I wasted my time. I said, that's when I told her about this boy. She needed corresponding courses. If I had done that, my life would have been different. Maybe yours would have been different. And hope it would have been better.
Can you describe that girlfriend that became your wife, that became my grandmother? Like the first time you met her? How did you meet her?
Oh, when I came to Virginia to go to school, she was... Brumman County didn't have a high school that's such for blacks, built off to itself. So they rented, the county paid St. Paul's for allowing us to study, get our high school training on St. Paul campus. And she was a student in college there. And there were four girls. I think I'm saying it right. Laura Bartley, Alice Stiff, Dorothy Tucker, and Williams. There were four of them. They used to congregate around Stiff brother's car. He was, James Stiff was a student in college at that time. And we were setting up in Webster Hall in our history class, and we see him down there by the car. And there was a classmate named Edmund Simmons. I asked him, who was those girls? Oh, they're college students. So I said, they had on the way they were dressed, that's the way he named them. I said, oh, I, when they named Alice Stiff, I said, well, I know her brother. I didn't know nothing about her. So that summer of 50, I helped my uncle save tobacco. And of course, her family was helping my uncle save tobacco. And we got the chance to talk. And from that summer working together in the tobacco, we started dating. Then, after a period of 4 years, we got married. Alice Stiff. In the meantime, when I proposed to her before I left here to go to Hot Springs. And she came up with the idea and said, well, since I'm coming out there to check the place over, why don't we get married? That was for Christmas of 55. So we got married on the 24th of December of 1955. And from getting married, we have been together up until now, 51 years, working on our 52nd year as of now.
How did my mom come about?
Well,
that fire and desire.
That's nature process. And to this union, we had two children, Andrea Renee Hendrick and Allison K. Hendrick, and they gave us four grandsons, Andrew Jacob Johnson, Frederick Adam Johnson, which was deceased or killed in a car accident at the age of 3. Brandon O'Neill Hicks, and Stephen Alexander Hicks. They're still my boys, but they're grown men now.
I guess I'm still growing.
Huh?
I'm still growing, so. like your memories of your father, my great granddaddy?
He was a hardworking man and wasn't wasteful.
Do you see yourself or in him or him in you? I guess him in you?
Yeah, I see a lot of myself. A lot of him in me. Because one thing my daddy didn't have, he was promoted to the third grade and he did not go any further. He went away. And I said, as a child, I want to be a little bit better than my daddy. So he insisted on us going to school. And I think that's where I am a step ahead of him. Because my reading and writing ability is a little better than his was.
Right.
Yeah, my granddad.
Instead of saying Adirondack a little while ago, you said Adirondack. And so we had to take away the money.
How you doing, nigga?
Margaret, what is
Neil
dealing
with?
Sentry. It's also an old word meaning to lynch. Margaret, what is halt? Right. Synonyms for talk.
You just let me know when you're good. This is my great grandma. We're here in Baltimore right now. And my great grandma is just, not a lot of people have a great grandma, so I had to get my great grandma on film to make sure that I always had an image. I guess because we're going to try to show this at the family reunion. Like the Hendrix side. Like, when you think about great granddad, like, what comes to mind? Like, your memories of great granddad.
I know you can. Well, I miss him and he gone. What can I do? What can I do? And I'm glad to have you here with me, beside me. Much as you used to run up the door after that. You run to the door looking for your mama.
Mm-hmm.
You can't remember that.
I remember running to the jungle.
Yeah, I had you in that walk. You go to that door and you just peep. But I said, look, so he's looking for his grandma, his mama.
The homemade one is it?
Then the Sunday one.
Well, I don't call it. Actually, that one is a cow puncher with the hook on it. Mm-hmm. But now with that hook, I'm sort of catch a calf around the neck, pull it to you, you know, stuff like that. But if you load the cow and don't want to act right, it was longer than what I got now. I don't cut it off. And you can stick it through the sideboard or through the fence. Jill it, and then go. And so that was.
Hey, sweetie, how you doing? And then to and she, mom, she don't be all right. She breathing there. They was shaking her and calling
her. They were shaking.
CPR.
Portugal.
Mm-hmm. CPR.
Oh,
okay.
No, but they had their chest thing.
Oh, okay.
That's
oh.
Something else.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. They didn't shock you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Because that number, I'm talking about television now. I don't know what to do.
Yeah, well, he had that
basically,
thing.
That's what it is. He's basically, that's what
it is. They do that, then they say something else.
Clear.
They don't right.
Because so many voters they're applying, they could kill you.
Right.
If you ain't dead, you know, that's why they don't want a person that's live. But see, you on ground, the person that they put in is on a stretcher, so it's an insulation in between that person and you. That, like a rubber piece,
because
that's the wheels, you know.
Uh-huh.
So,
right.
So you they grounded.
Mm-hmm.
All have mercy.
Yes.
All have mercy.
And I know that Dee and them was coming home from the hospital, but, you know, we were talking on telephone and all that, and no more Pete and them coming, so I know how you were feeling when you took her out of here. So I said, I'll wait till they come and then we'll tell you. But I told them you were stronger than
we are,
than they really realized. Because you know about death, and you know. We got to go, right.
I talked to both people over the phone, you know, telling them about these things. I said, God just says you be ready.
That's what it says.
Because you don't know when I'm...
That's what it says. Be ready because you don't know when I'm... Whether you're ready or not. The day. All the day.
When I come, you got to go. So get the house in order. Said Stephen and them was coming over, and she asked me, hey, Mama, don't you want me to get your hair down there? I said, no, I said, I'm clean. I ain't going nowhere. I'm in the house. Mama, I'll fix your hair. And she up there and there, hiding the sickness, trying to do something. She was faithful for doing things all the time.
I tell her she needs to slow down.
Yeah, I said she don't
took. I said you too fast.
Yes.
And we go to the grocery. I said, now you know I can't walk fast as you.
She moving. I tell you, she
moving. You know I can't walk as fast as you. I said you know.
That, and doing something all the time. I told her she got that from me. I can't do. So I go somewhere and sit down.
I'm old as mama,
you know what?
I'm old as bad as
she. You know why I'm clapping my hands? Oh, Alice tell me sometimes, you don't do nothing here. I laugh. and I do something. And I sit down and something. Oh, why she say I don't do nothing there? Somebody else is calling. Want something?
Yeah.
Well, you know, you go do that. Well, I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna say something simple. I can piddle around there on that place.
Hey, Charles. Yes.
Stuff like that. And I don't get near as tired as I do going to Richmond and sitting in the hospital or in the doctor's office. And I drive back and I'm tired. But now.
But we should slow down. But you get to the place you hate to slow down. Because I know I should slow down. I still want to do that.
Yeah.
And I don't get over the hood.
And you do what you can do.
Do what
you
can do.
And even so, it might not be much, but you do that.
Yeah. That child would do everything. My cup, I take a cup of water. You know, now I can do this. One time I really couldn't do it. She always did. Now she's still done. I bring her water up when I come home. You know, I call that a young thing. Mm-hmm. I cut your, I didn't catch the banners or I got one thing. I'm off the step.
Yeah,
child, stay busy.
Yeah, she's
all
the time.
All the time.
Yeah, that's what
always sitting there and sometimes talk. She don't bounce to got into a job. Keep thank God. She was able to do it. She did what she did too much.
I don't know. I ain't gonna say she did too much. You know, there's a whole lot of people. Don't want to because she didn't get no extra.
Yeah. Yeah. So,
the bottom line is, back to what I said, when it's time, you're going.
Yeah, regardless.
Yes.
Regardless.
Whether you sit down and do nothing, saving yourself.
Yeah.
Where you get up and just keep working.
Okay.
You don't remember a man that lived over there in the house when he lived in the heights, a young fella.
Yeah.
That name Walter Tills.
Right.
Well, she realized him last Saturday.
Well, let me, I'll get back to you and that's in progress.
That man was a farmer.
Okay, then I will do that. Okay, then.
And a lawyer.
Summertime, okay then, all right, back, I talk to you later, right? Mm-hmm. One time, hey, I'm not raised to buy them, just logging and had his calendar raising eight, and he's 7 to 6 years old, 4 years older than I. I knew we won't fall apart, but
he got married at an early age with his wife. And daddy said he drank muddy water, keep him looking for him. But
how you doing on
I'm imagining this is my favorite brother-in-law. You understand? This is my favorite brother-in-law. Oh, you didn't know that for anybody.
Well, you a black ain't no in there.
Oh, Lord.
What are you doing in there?
I thought you.
You ain't on there?
Sure.
Yeah, good. Yeah.
No,
What's your name? Anaya. Oh, I thought you were on Anaya.
Right.
Yeah, what's my mother say?
Jacob just called me back. He said he doesn't have a way of getting in touch with his father. But I told him if he called, I'm going call you here because you're burning the sunlight. You had to make a move.
I told you he didn't know how to tell time.
Yeah, I could have told you that, huh? He don't need to talk about you no more. But I've dealt with him. He definitely have no room to talk about you no more. Because he's the slowest thing I've seen since molasses. Matter of fact, he's slower than molasses. Molasses will beat him right.
He's slow and you too fast.
Yeah, I agree with that.
I reckon that's in our gene. She said,
Dad, can you reach the cups?
What cup, baby?
I don't think he's tall enough.
She said,
yeah, we might not be tall enough. I might not have this whole
operation
is
fake.
A small one. You want some water? Which one,
My best friend wanted a strawberry with cups.
Oh, okay. Her best friend wants some strawberry with cups.
Okay.
Problem.
Can I have a cup of chewed strawberries?
Oh, you want some too with strawberries?
Yes.
Okay. Strawberries. You need two of them already.
I couldn't reach the cups.
Like Robin,
I'll go
all
the way to
get
a strawberry with
cups out. Inez. This one's for your best friend. And yours is coming.
My mouth.
Okay.
I did know the whole thing.
That was yours. Please don't drop them.
But I can get 3 months of medicine for the price of 2 months. And for brand name medicines, I have to pay $40 for the 3 months. And if it's generic, I have to pay $10. Yeah,
that's it.
You know, it's too much.
And you know what
These people that we put over here in Washington every year, we put the same stinking people back in. They ain't doing nothing for us.
Nothing.
And all this stuff that's really expensive and hard on us, they don't never open up about it.
Oh, yeah.
Nothing. Y'all know. We have messed the bed. And then now there's a black man.
Wow.
Okay.
Did you get 54?
Yeah, the 54 is upstairs.
A 9.
On there. So you go and turn it on. And
4.
Whenever it finish, then you know you can stop it and put it on 45 if you want to, okay?
You want to take more? Want to stand up there? Okay, you're on camera. Do whatever you want. You can dance, you can sing.
You want to dance?
Whatever you want to do.
Okay, I'll put the music on so you can dance.
Got the onions from there.
Yeah, okay, okay.
Don't put the thing on.
You want to dance?
No.
No.
Two. Three. You did. I don't know.
But you gotta say something so there's some sound.
I just said something.
Do you want to see it now?
Yes.
Okay, you gotta get up.
Okay. See.
Come on.
It's too hot. Can't tell ya. Okay. That shit, and my dad was trying to cry for her.
You want to show the picture?
Mm-hmm.
Who's this?
This right here is my grandma Vera.
Oh, put it up here. Oh, no. Hold the picture. Right. You gotta back up some. So I can see the picture. Okay, there you go.
This right here is my grandma, Vera. This one right here is my grandma, Barbara. And this one is my aunt, Dee Dee. This one is my Nana.
Let's see. Let's hold it up to the camera. Let's get a good shot. Okay, hold still. Get a nice shot of your picture. Very nice.
Let me see it.